And now the holiday season is here, which means you may feel like you have to spend time with some toxic and narcissistic family members. So let's talk about strategies on how you can maintain your control throughout the entire season. My name is Kevin, and this is The Royal We. Now, to start these strategies off, let's talk about this idea of you feeling like you have to go somewhere. You have to be with narcissistic people. That is bogus, and it already creates tension inside of you. Let's cut through to the chase. The reality is you don't have to do anything. You don't have to be here. You don't have to be there. If you want to, you can lock yourself up in a closet and isolate yourself the entire time. You don't have to do anything for anybody. I believe the truth of the matter is what you're really struggling with is the dilemma of you're either damned if you do with these people or you're damned if you don't. In other words, if you go and spend time with them during the holidays, then you run the risk of being the talk of the town and all their slander and negativity, right? If you do go and spend time with them, or did I say if you do go? If you do go or if you don't go, it doesn't matter. You run the risk either way of being the talk of the town and running the risk of being up against their slander and their negativity. And this creates this confusion, this debacle. Should I go? Shouldn't I go? And the best way that we cope with this is saying, well, I feel like I have to. No, you don't have to. So let's regain our control as part of the strategies and just saying, okay, listen, I'm not going to feel like I have to do anything. I am now going to make the choices of exactly what I'm going to do this holiday season. And now we can get into the actual strategies. Strategy number one, get your mind right when it comes to understanding the toxic and narcissistic people. When I say get your mind right, I'm talking about understand your expectations. Don't have any expectations of toxic people, period, end. Do not expect them to be vicious and nasty and cruel to you. Understand that that's a part of their character, but don't expect that that's how they're going to treat you this holiday season. Because if you expect that, in my experience, they can actually turn out to be charming and loving, and you've wasted all of your energy being uptight over nothing. All right? At the same time, don't expect that they are going to be nice and loving and giving and deep and want to connect with you. If you expect that, then you'll be let down by their coldness and their cruelty and their negativity, right? So don't have any expectations from them. Instead, change your expectations within yourself and expect that they're toxic and leave it at that. And then expect for yourself to allow them to be however they're going to be. Expect that you are just going to be there and you're going to be in control of yourself no matter who and what face they decide to show you. Now, expectations is everything going into it. That's the first thing you can control is your expectations. Have none about them. Only focus on the expectations that you have of yourself and understanding that they're toxic. Number two, the second strategy, make plans. And the second part of that is stick to your plans. So you make the plans instead of being strung around by their plans. And narcissists like to make the plans. Come over here at this time, and we're going to eat at this time, and then we're going to go do this, and then we're going to do that. They like to control the whole shit circus, right? So instead, you're going to approach it with your plans, and you're going to say, listen, thank you for the invitation. I can go for 2 hours between this time and this time, and then I've got other things to do, but I'd really like to see you for these couple of hours, okay? And then make sure you stick to that. So you go for the 2 hours, and let's say everything is going good and you're actually having conversations with toxic people and it's going well. Don't be that person that gets stuck there for a third hour and then a fourth hour and you look like a fool because now you've just went against your own plans. Not only that, they know that. They tried to get you to go past your own plans because, again, they try to control you. So you're there thinking that you're just having a deep conversation and, well, I don't want to leave. You know, you're excited for the first time. You're connecting with the narcissist. No, no. Stick to your plans. Don't be that fool. go there for the couple of hours that you said you were going to go there for and then leave. This is respectable. And you want to be respectable around toxic people. So stick to your plans. Even if you're having the best time of your life, don't go for that last drink. No, just if you're having the best time, then leave saying, wow, I just had the best time with them. That was great. And let it be. Let it go, right? There's nothing worse than staying for that third, fourth hour. Everything looks good. And then suddenly the claws come out and then you're leaving. And then the next day you're the reason the party was ruined, right? All because you didn't stick to your plan. So make a plan. How long you're going to be there, what time you're going to arrive, and when you're going to leave. And that's it. Now, also make sure you're going because there's one or two people who are worth your time and going. When I say worth your time, meaning they're not toxic. They love you. They care about you. Whatever, you care about them. If there's none of these people, then this conversation doesn't make sense and there's no reason for you to go at all, okay? Now then, that was the second strategy. So the first one's get your mind right, your expectations right. Know you're dealing with toxic people. Number two, make your plan and stick with them. That's the second one. Number three, stay focused on the reason you're going. So if there's a couple of people, one or two people that you care about and who care about you, then focus on them. Go to spend time with them. Go to share your love and your life and whatever's going on in your life. Share it with those people, no matter how many, one or two, no matter how small. You can be kind to the toxic people. You could be still yourself, but don't get involved in deep conversations or anything like that with the toxic people. Go and focus your energy on the ones who deserve it while being kind to everybody else, all right? These are strategies that have worked for me and they will work for you. Listen, I wanna be a part of your healing journey and I wanna help strategize with you even more if you need it. Down below in the description box, you will find one-on-one consultation options with me. We could do a telephone call, we could do a FaceTime or a WhatsApp call, or we could do an email consultation. It's up to you. Also down in the description box, you'll find links. You'll find links to the Royal We live chat every Monday night where we go live as a community. You can call in and ask questions for free if you'd like. You'll find the link down below. Royal We Fellowship, which is an all new church. It's a ministry. Every Saturday morning, we talk about narcissism and toxicity from the perspective of the ancient literature of the Bible. It's unlike any other Bible study you've been a part of. Every Saturday morning at 9 a.m., you can find the link to that down below as well. Also, you can find Royal We Apparel. The link is down below so you can support this channel and get some Royal We merchandise. And I'll be back with more videos for you right here on the Royal We.